described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
The Southern Poverty Law Center presents Bullied.
The first time I ever told anyone I was gay, it was my grandmother. I spent a lot of weekends at my grandmother's house, just her and I. We'd watch TV, we would hang out, we'd eat ice cream.
He speaks to high school students in a gymnasium.
When I was seven, my uncle was coming to visit quite a bit in the summer, and my uncle had went away, and he basically was the only person in my family that went away and made money, and he came back and he always had a Cadillac. As a kid, I absolutely loved his Cadillac, and it was kind of a strange obsession where I would go and play with the buttons. I would take naps in the back seat of the Cadillac.
Some kids laughed.
So my uncle had come to visit, him and his partner. My uncle was gay, and he had left, and I was hanging out with my grandmother in her bedroom, and we were watching TV, and I said, "Grandma, I want to tell you something," and she said, "Yes." I said, "I'm a homosexual." I probably couldn't even pronounce the word, to be honest, and she just looked at me and smiled and said, "Honey, you don't have to be gay to have a Cadillac."
More of the kids laugh and smile. Title, narrated by Jane Lynch.
In the late 1980s, Jamie Nabozny was in middle school, seemingly leading the life of a typical American teenager.
Old photos are shown.
My childhood was pretty good overall. My family did have some problems, but I always knew that my parents loved me and cared about me and I was taken care of.
In a photo, he sits with two brothers, a mom and dad.
The Nabozny family lived in a small Wisconsin town on the banks of Lake Superior.
I describe Ashland as being as far as you can go in Wisconsin without falling into the lake.
Former teacher Nina Buxbaum.
It is, in the summer, a wonderful, beautiful spot. And in the winter, it's 5 feet of snow and cold.
Jamie kept his sexual orientation a secret from his parents and friends. Until one day in the seventh grade.
Well, I think he just said, "You know, Mom, I'm gay." I don't think I was that shocked.
Jamie.
And my mom was, you know, she was crying and she said, I already knew and it doesn't matter, I love you.
I think I knew from the time Jamie was like five that he was gay.
Jamie's mother, Carol Rosen.
A mother knows that, you know. So I just thought, okay, if this is what he says he's gay. Then we need to deal with it, and, you know, I just need to start learning some more about it.
My dad took a while to accept that I was gay, and I think one of the things that kind of happened is that eventually my harassment became the bigger issue in our lives, bigger than my sexuality, and as a parent, his job was to protect me and to make sure that I was safe.
An American flag flies outside Ashland Middle School. In a reenactment, students sit at a classroom, and a teacher turns from a whiteboard.
Jamie was not out to his friends, but many classmates at Ashland Middle School saw him as gay. That was enough for some campus bullies.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.